Peace. Enjoy the taste of despair.
Here's the Thank you.
enjoy the taste of despair.
Thank you. Enjoy the taste of this.
I didn't realize I'm muted. I've been talking since Poppy Bobby. I generally thought I was not muted because when he said Super V, I says, yeah, I'm using Super V. And then I says, oh, I'm also using Unlimited Devil Trigger. What the fuck? I didn't realize I'm muted. I've just literally just said like a bunch of shit as well. Oh dear. How many times has that happened? To be fair. Oh. That's happened quite a lot. I don't know I'm muted until someone comes in and says, by the way, you're muted, dipshit. Come out with a full fucking paragraph and shit. Yeah. What the fuck? Plus, you would be able to see me if you could see my mouth. Because obviously, I was talking. But you can't see my mouth moving because of my mic being in the way. But yeah. Yeah, because literally, as soon as you said, oh, when you says hi, G, I says, right, yeah. Hey, what's up, dude? How's it going? And then, as soon as you said Super V, I says, yeah, I'm using Super V, and then I went, it's Unlimited Devil Trigger. And as soon as you said that, you pretty much said it at the same time. But yeah, like I was saying with this, it would be kind of cool for the last stage. I'm presuming it's going to be 101. Oh, shit. I'm presuming it's going to be 101, and it's going to be Virgil. But I think it'd be kind of cool if it's Virgil and Dante. And then you fight them inside the demon world in the ending. We're in that bit. That'd be kind of cool. You've got Dante and Virgil to eat and fight and shit. And then that's when I started saying that on Bloody Palace for 4, there was an achievement on the remastered version that they did. 60 frame bollocks. There was actually an achievement to complete Bloody Palace. Whoa, is this a boss? Oh! Look at this little bitch. With all these fireballs and shit I do. Yeah, also as well earlier, when I says, oh, there he is shooting his beam. There was that thing that I said the other day when I says, oh, there was a scene in one of the, I think it was the reveal trailer. Yeah, you seen Nightmare, the big thing, in that fucking, the second boss, well, the third level boss, that big dude. you start seeing them doing wrestling shit. And the axe, whoa, he's gone devil trigger already. What the fuck's up with him? When I says, oh, they start doing wrestling type shit, they actually started doing it. As soon as I said it, because I realized, I went, oh, fucking Nightmare, he's not that big. And then I clicked on, because on the trailer, Nightmare's huge. And then he starts doing the thing, and then as soon as I got him down, as soon as I got him down, I did the thing to absorb him with V, and then a big Nightmare came, and then that's when they started doing the wrestling shit. Because I generally thought that, oh, they probably just took it out of the game, because you never fight him. The only time you fight him is when you do this the whole three boss sequence on 16, 15, or whatever it is. Oh, man. You're having a fucking laugh. So that means for the next one, it's going to be him when you fight him as Dante in the dream world or whatever. I'd say this is the biggest advantage that you get, is that the guys actually, the enemies actually concentrate on these. I say that's the biggest advantage that you get with V. Fucking demolish the bastard. Fucking Nightmare, pick him up, powerbomb him or something. That'd actually be kind of funny if he did that. You just see Nightmare just pick him up. Starts doing fucking Hulk off the Avengers with Loki. Just picks him up by the leg and just fucking starts slamming him. No. Imagine how much. Oh, I've just realized though. With Dante. I've just realized with Dante, you can do it piece of piss. If you've got unlimited devil trigger, just keep going fucking ultimate devil form. I won't be surprised if you could actually just stay in it. So for sequences like this, I fucking hate that attack. I absolutely hate it. So for sequences like this, you can just go ultimate double form and just demolish everything. Yep, sure is. So that's why I wanted to do it with V, because, oh dear, I hate that attack. That's a stupid attack, especially for V. Can't do shit. Wait, I wouldn't be surprised if I fucking do this. Unless if it gives me health. Oh, what does it do? Oh. I get no health. No health. Because that's what I wondered with Indy, with V. Yeah. I'm just so I still personally think when he's in that form, he just looks like Guyver to me. That's all it looks like. It just looks like Guyver. Oh mate, I've just realised. It would be kind of sick to see Guyver in Mortal Kombat. He would fucking fit it as well. Because the type of person he is. Well, it's an alien. It's a suit. It's an alien suit. And it takes over this human, obviously. And he just gets like superhuman strength and shit. And then there's other ones. Like other suits that control other people, and then there's like one that's like the pure one, like the pure Guyver or something, and it's like a proper gory thing as well. They rip each other's fucking heads off and shit. But this is a very old film, fucking hell. It's very old. Kinda looks like Guyver. From when I first ever seen him fight Guyver. I wonder if you could grab him. I bet you can. When you're playing as Nero, I bet you can grab him. He's gonna do that thingy attack, innit? He's gonna do that thingy attack. That. Oh. Get in the beam. He's doing shit. He's just being fucking naughty now. He's just being naughty. It's just being noise. Mate, if he don't give me low life, I don't think I might not even beat Bird. Surely that he will. Surely. Oh god. Oh, this dude is. This dude. Well, his form. I don't know how to say his name. All he is he's Virgil from 3. That's all he is. He's Virgil's form from 3. Since he does all the kicks, he's doing the kicks and the teleports. Cause it's when you fight Virgil for the second time. Cause those kicks and shit, that's what Virgil does. Oh my god. Give me life. Virgil time. Mate, if it's Dante and Virgil. Find out. Is it Dante and Virgil? Wait, how the fuck are you gonna fight him? Since he parries everything. Oh. You're fighting yourself, mate. Oh. I wonder what version it is. Is it the one where you fight? It's the one when you fight Nero. There it is. It's the one when you fight Nero. He's weakened. He's a bitch. Like he's just letting me hit him. Oh. Whoa! What a combo! Get out.
Slicing. Take them. Cut you down.
To be fair, I reckon that's the main reason why they've made it so the computer, why the enemies concentrate on those three mainly, because these two slow. Is a human. You can technically say he's a human, which he technically is, because he's Virgil's humanity side. Because if this was fucking real thing, Virgil could just slice. See you later, then. Fucking mug the bastard. Mug him. Get his wallet and car keys. Because I've just clicked on as well. He's not got the gloves. I've just clicked on. That might be the reason why the boss that I've just versed, that might be the reason why he does Virgil's shit from free. Because that's when he's got the gloves. Well, when he's killed Beowulf and he takes his soul and then he gets the gloves. Yeah, they got me with that one, boy. It's fucking, I like to cheat fucking thing, innit? I like to cheat double ganger. Fucking attack him before he's even fucking spawned. What game's that off? Game that likes to do that, what game were it? Where they do attacks before they're even on the screen, or before they've even spawned, they start doing an animation for an attack. So as soon as they come up, bang, they hit you. Cheating again. Yeah, I know it's on Dante Must Die mode as well, so it's obviously on the hardest. It's cheating. The amount of times it knocked him in the air. We do. You. He absorbed him. What the fuck? He fucking absorbed him. What? What the